Venus is Earth's nearest neighbor in space and Earth's closest relative in size. However, any other similarities are completely hidden from view beneath a thick layer of clouds. Only radio telescopes can map Venus using the technique known as radar. A radio telescope sends beam of radio waves toward Venus. The waves go straight through the clouds and hit the surface, then they bounce back to the telescope's receivers. Waves return at different times depending on what they hit on the ground. For example, waves that hit a tall mountain will start their journey back sooner than those waves that have to travel deeper before they hit anything. The differences in return times are therefore differences in height of the surface. As the radar beam plots the bumps and dips across the planet, we can assemble a map of mountains and craters. Early radar in the 60s was low resolution, and yet, with it, radio astronomers found a mountain on the surface and watched it change position over a few hours. The mountain moved from right to left, which meant that Venus was spinning clockwise in the opposite direction of every other planet in the solar system. Spacecraft visiting Venus have made much higher resolution maps of the planet beneath the clouds, showing us a desert world. We see lava eruptions that have been squashed into giant pancake-shaped hills under the extreme pressure of the thick hot air above them. We also see many volcanic mountains taller than Mount Everest across our neighbor's surface. The volcanoes on Venus may be active. We have measured extreme and sudden changes in sulfur dioxide on Venus. The simplest explanation is that an active volcano is burping tons of this poisonous gas into its atmosphere.